sunrise over the deck of the USS George-HW Bush. On board, the crew of this 90,000 tons of US national sovereignty prepare for the day's critical missions.
Some 5,000 people employed on this ship, tending to around about 60 jets. And it was these jets on August the 6th that dropped the first bombs on Iraq in this latest conflict against ISIS.
In June, midway through a nine-month tour, this $6 billion military asset was redeployed to the Persian Gulf, where it's now a key component in operations against ISIS. Captain Dan Cheever, a 20-year Navy veteran and fighter pilot himself, oversees the ship's strike planes.
So the mission is to project power from the carrier over both Iraq and Syria and to defeat the terrorist enemy.
The USS George H.W. Bush is the flagship of Carrier Strike Group 2, which also includes five destroyers and a cruiser, all under the command of Rear Admiral DeWolf C. Miller.
Chuck Hagel has said that air power alone will not degrade and destroy ISIL. Do you agree?
So, good question. What I will tell you again, my focus is on that air power. Are we being effective in how we do it? I will tell you that we've seen great effect on the ground in Iraq when working with the Iraqi security forces. This isn't going to be measured in weeks and months. This is going to be years. And I do agree with Secretary Hagel that it's going to take a combination of forces on the ground and air power to achieve that.
To stand on the bridge of this 4.5-acre carrier is to understand the enormity of the task required of a naval captain. Anybody.
This is the size, I believe, of the Empire State. It has some 5,000 staff, many of whom are young men and women living on this ship together for months at a time. You've got millions of tons of fuel and ordnance, of course.
Absolutely.
Does it not keep you awake at night when you're in charge of?
Well, absolutely it does. I mean, bottom line is my phone rings. I'm on duty 24/7.
Nighttime brings no respite from the noise and punishing work. These planes returning from another mission somewhere over Iraq or Syria. The sun set over the Gulf hours ago, but a day's job is never done for these men and women of the US Navy.